Hey guys, my name is Shanjai Raj. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to make a simple web app using the Google Books API. So this is just ISBN API. So you type in the ISBN and you click start reading and you'll get the book itself to read. So what I've done is using Bootstrap 4, I made the API. And so if I click on it, there's no value. So it says not found. So validation is working. So if I paste in and valid ISBN, which is actually a working book, which is Money Master the Game, is just a random book, but it's working. So if I click start reading, the book will actually come here. So if you can see Master the Game by Tony Robbins. So if I click on auto turn, it's gonna go down every 3 seconds. So if you see every 3 seconds, it's gonna go down by each page, so like that. So this is such an easy web app that we're gonna work on. So let's just get started. I'm gonna open Visual Studio Code, open folder. I'm gonna create a new folder called Books App. So I'm gonna select that folder, and inside the folder you're gonna have a basic HTML and app.js. the CSS is going to be implemented using Bootstrap. So index.html, app.js, and for the index.html we need an XML file using Google, because we don't need HTML, but instead we need XML. So in the Google Books API documentation we have that, so I'm going to copy that. I'm gonna paste it in my Visual Studio Code, and after that we need a script tag, which is also from the Google API documentation. Actually, you can find a lot of stuff if you're interested to expand this website. So here it is. So if I click on that and copy it, Visual Studio Code back, go down and paste it. And I actually wanna not waste time making the HTML and CSS. I just wanna open up my previous previous folder where I had my code set up. So I'm gonna get all of that, so I don't wanna actually waste time. We can focus on the JavaScript mostly. So until this much, so I'm gonna paste it in the middle. So I'm using an extension called Live Server, which is an extension through Visual Studio Code. So this is how it should be looking like, because we only have the UI set up. So now we're gonna work with the JavaScript. First of all, what we wanna do is make a script tag. And inside that, I want to get some constant variables. So let me just explain what's going on. We have a header which just says Google API app, it doesn't do anything, it's using Bootstrap classes. And after that, we have a container with a card. So the thing we are going to change and use is the input field here, which is enter ISBN. We are gonna get that value and pass it to the ISBN parameter, and then start reading button and the auto turn button is the only thing we are gonna be using. So let me get all of them. So auto turn has a class of auto, and start reading has a class of BTN primary and ISBN. So we are gonna get all of them right now. I'll say const button equals document dot query selector, and inside that I'll say btn primary, and I just wanna duplicate them. I'll say ISBN, and here I'll say auto. Inside this I'll simply say ISBN, because we have a class of ISBN. And here we have a class of auto. So we actually got everything we can deal with the Google API. So first of all, we want to say Google dot books dot load, and that's a function. Inside that we pass in an object which contains the language that we want to use. So let me just check for the documentation and show you guys how it works. So here we have second information, which is a google.books.load. You can actually use that as well. So inside the parameter we're gonna say language, and the language is en, which is English. You can pass in a lot of stuff. You can get the input and pass it to that, but for the tutorial we're gonna use that. And after that we want to make a function that turns the page each 33 seconds. So I'm gonna name it next step, and I'm gonna get the viewer as a parameter, because we are gonna pass the variable as a viewer in the initialize function, which we will connect now. So I wanna say window dot set timeout, which is equal to a function. So in this we are gonna get we are gonna turn the page, and we are gonna pass the parameter as well. So viewer dot next page, and after that we are gonna pass in next step and viewer. Now this is not fully done yet, because we wanna pass this, we wanna call this function in the other function, which is called initialize. After that we want to make a function that actually returns an alert saying that the book is not found if the ISBN is not valid, because only some books are found by the Google Books API. So keep that in mind. So if I want to name it alert not found, and I just want to alert out book not found, and there it is. So now we are gonna work with the books itself. So I wanna make a function which is called initialize. You can call it whatever you want, but initialize. So inside this we wanna make the variable that we are gonna use to call the next step function, which is var viewer. So inside this we're gonna have a new Google book with the ISBN. So new Google dot books dot default, I'm getting that spelling wrong, default viewer. So let me check the documentation, give you guys some idea of what's going on. So if we just go to the source code itself here, if you can see we are having a new object, and if you go down they have all kinds of you know, documentation descriptions and all kind of stuff. So inside the default viewer we wanna give where we wanna place the book. So if you saw, we have an empty div here named viewer canvas, so that's where we're gonna be having it. And I also set the width and height as an inline styles, but you can also style it as well. So I'm gonna say document dot get element by ID, and it says viewer canvas. So you want to get that and pass it, which will put the book, the current book, inside the canvas. And we want to load the book with the ISBN that the person is giving, not a default ISBN, but the ISBN of the input field we are getting. So if you actually see, we have an input field, so the value of that we should get it and pass it into the parameter. So viewer.load, and we want to say ISBN. Now ISBN is not the only way you could get it, you could get it through other ways as well. So make sure to check the API documentation out. So I want to say ISBN dot value, which we actually took over here. So This is the input field, and here we specify its value. So here we want to call the next step function, and also we want to give the second parameter, which basically means that if it's not found, run this function. We could also do other functions, but here we will just pass in the allot not found function, which will basically return whatever inside the function, which is the alert. So now we want to call the next step function, next step, and we want to pass in the viewer. It's pretty much done, and at the end we want to say we want to call the function to the API as well. Google dot books dot set on load callback. Now this can get kind of complicated. It also was complicated for me. I put like a lot of hard work, and not necessarily, but it's like 10:15 right now, but I'm recording the video, so it can be quite hard, but while you do it again and again, you can get it. So I think it's pretty much done. We wanna make a basically, if I go, you can't see anything, because we, even though we put, let's just say, I'm gonna copy an ISBN. Even if I copy the valid ISBN and paste it in, if I click it, nothing will happen, because we have not added an event listener. We have not made the function for the click. So I want to make an event listener. Click on click, we want to run the initialize function, and also not only that, even for the auto, we want to run the next step viewer, and that's pretty much it. It should work. So right now I go, click start reading, it should bring up the book as well, or else it might show up an error. Let me go to the console. Viewer is not defined. Yeah, okay. At what line? Oh, over there. Next step. Oh wait, I don't want to call this over here. I want to call this right here, so that it's my mistake, because once we click it, we want to call the function. So we don't want to call it on the top, because viewer is not defined on the top. We only start defining it right here. So it kind of should work now. It says Google is not defined. At what line isn't it defined? On top itself. Let me check the API. Real quick, so google.books.load. I think you should have the script on top of it. Yeah, that's the problem. Should have the script on top of it, not at the bottom. So I'm sorry, my mistake. So hope it works, by the way. Yeah, it should work. B is undefined. Oh, what line is it? I don't know that. So if I click on start reading, book not found. Why does it say that? Used to work. So it's working. It was just a syntax error or something. So it's working. We got the book. So auto-turn should also work. Like for every 3 seconds, pages should go down automatically. So if that works, that's cool. I don't think it's working. What's the problem? I think there's a problem. B is undefined. Why does that? It's not my problem. Let me check once and I'll actually get back with you guys, because so guys, the problem was I actually didn't pass the time. Should be 3000. So I actually figured this out, so so it should work. So I can start reading. Should get the book. Now this is gonna apply to any book. Now if you can see, so it's it's going automatically every page. So that's about for this video, guys. I hope you guys enjoy. Now the source code is gonna be in the GitHub page in the description down below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.